Hey there, golfers. I'm Drew Mahol, the Second Swing Golf at the Cobra Puma booth, joined by Jose Miraflor to talk about the Cobra MIM wedges. You made some improvements to 2020, obviously, but let's get to kind of the introduction and the story behind MIM and the metal injection molding process. That's been huge for you guys, and it, you know, kind of is the catalyst for the performance in these wedges, right?
Thanks, Drew. Appreciate that. Yeah, MIM technology, metal injection molding, we brought to the marketplace. You've been seeing MIM products for a long time probably, but didn't know you had it. It's normally used to shape little pieces in a very refined way to fit in little nooks and crannies. So all those tungsten weights you've seen in products over the years in golf products are MIM shaped. So MIM gives us precision shaping. Why not have that in a wedge, right? And that's what we thought it would be great to bring to the market, 100% MIM product, so that the shaping is perfect. It's polished by robots, never polished by hand. So probably the most perfect rinds you're going to find in a golf club.
Sure. Now you introduced MIM a little bit in 2019. Now you've added some features, some different finishes, some different grinds. So why don't you get into really what's new for 2020?
Absolutely. So in 2019, we launched the Chrome series. It was just our standard grind, the versatile grind. It's right here in black. It has a little bit of relief in heel and toe. Very versatile around the golf course, around most courses in the United States or around the world. This year we added this new black finish, QPQ, quench, polish, quench. It's a finishing technique. It oxidizes, changes the color of the wedge to help make it darker. Why dark? Darkness helps diffuse light. So you won't have to worry about glare as you're playing around during certain times of days as you open the wedge up. Very reduced glare, which is great. And then we also added other grinds. So for those of you who may play in softer conditions and you might like a wedge that's a little bit thicker or in the sole, or maybe soft bunker play, we have this wide low grind made in a 56, 58, and 60. Again, great for those places that are softer or fluffier types of conditions in bunkers. And for those of you who would love just a classic rind, not much relief, but maybe a lot of bounce, you play the classic rind, and it's a great wedge, all around great wedge that you can utilize, and then you use these grinds to fine tune your bag. We see a lot of guys go with a versatile grind in a 60 and maybe a wide low in a 56, or maybe a classic in a 52. So depending on how you use the wedges, you can have different grinds.
Sure. Now, one of the things, just by looking at them, I think on the club face, I noticed kind of a unique groove pattern, perhaps, maybe inside the grooves there. How did that come about? Because it looks a little different than maybe you see most places.
Yeah, thanks for that. Yeah, on the face of these wedges, we always 100% mill wedges, faces flat, and then the grooves in. Then there's a pattern on it we're calling a variable face roughness. Our engineers have found a way to maximize that roughness because it is governed by the USGA, but we maximize it for both peak height and average roughness in between the grooves. We call that the land area. And if you can maximize that type of effect on your shorter shots, your 30-yard shots where you're not swinging full and your grooves aren't hitting the edge of the golf ball or the cover of the golf ball really hard, those little micro grooves can help give you a little bit more spin to help manage those shots when you short side yourself.
Yeah, and you always want as much control as you can get, right?
Absolutely. So,
and from a fitting perspective, obviously second swing, we really push fitting and club fitting and making sure that golfers are playing, you know, the equipment that's right for their swing. And from a wedge perspective, the different grinds, the different bounce, etc., it all plays a big impact on your swing and the contact you're gonna make. So Can you tell golfers a little bit about, you know, again, how each of these grinds are gonna fit and what golfers are missing out on if they're playing the wrong grind?
Absolutely. See your second swing guys, because they're gonna show you how these wedges work. You're gonna be fit for them. You should be asked what type of turf conditions that you would play in. You should hit on the lie board and see your lie angle, but not only lie angle, but your centerness on the sole of what contacts the ground. Say, for example, you hit it on the back of the wedge a lot because you do apply a lot of loft. You can pick a grind that works better for you there. If you're sliding under the golf ball and you feel like you're hitting it too high, you may need a wider sole. If you feel like you're bouncing up in the ball, you might need a versatile grind to slide under a little bit more. These guys are great at figuring out the right grind for you. These wedges were designed for different turf conditions. So versatile, like I said, all around good turf conditions, but if it gets too soft, I'd be trying out a wide low. And if you're looking for just an easy wedge that you don't open up the club a lot, this classic grind has a little bit more bounce so that you can keep the wedge a little bit more square and it doesn't let it dig that much.
Awesome. Well, Jose, thank you for having us here in the Cobra booth. It's always a great time, and yeah, he's got the atmosphere is lively, got music playing, so we always love stopping by. Cobra Mim Wedges in 2020 should be great options for golfers out there looking to improve their short game. Options for every swinger out there as well. So again, Jose, thank you for joining and providing information
for us. Thank you to you and the team as well.